还记得 Joe Biden 当时在竞选的时候以人道主义批评川普的边境政策吗？最近美国，而且跟美国关系很特别的国家海地，先是总统被暗杀，接着爆发了非常不幸的地震，出现了大量的难民，于是难民之间互相口耳相传，他们逃到了靠近德州边境那个叫 Del Rio 这个城市，这里头有一个桥布满了这些难民，当地的警官们骑着马拿着鞭子痛打这些难民，而且最后把他们送回国内。海蒂说，有些难民说，美国不再是我认识的国家。最严重的是海蒂总统被刺杀之后，美国才刚刚派出一位海蒂美国去海蒂的特使，这位特使在9月22号，他不能够忍受美国总统 Joe Biden 不闻不问这件事情，也不能够接受现在美国 Biden 政府的做法，他决定写信给国务卿 Blinken 辞去海地特使的职务，表示抗议。而这个事情重创 Biden 的形象，人们说他到底是不是一个伪君子。
这不是2015年的法国加莱港，这是2021年的美国德州。
Have you seen anything like this before?
No.No, this is the first.
This is what the U.S.'s immigration waiting room looks like in Del Rio, Texas, a border town 150 miles west of San Antonio.
上万难民多数来自海地，困在连接美墨两国的德利奥国际大桥下，宛如法国加莱的丛林翻版。
If you come to the United States illegally, you will be returned. Your journey will not succeed, and you will be endangering your life.And your family's lives.
If you look closely, you'll see that these are men, women, children. I see pregnant women, infants.
Living under this bridge, they lack the basic necessities. No shelter, food, water, or sanitation. More than 12,000 people are waiting to be processed by immigration authorities.Many made the desperate journey through Central and South America, fleeing poverty, violence, and natural disasters, looking for a better life.
怎知等在他们前方的不是更好的未来，而是冷冰冰的鞭子。
The El Paso Times reported that a mounted border patrol agent was seen wielding a whip during an encounter with Haitian migrants.
这一幕令人不禁想起美国南北战争时期，南方庄园里奴隶主压迫黑奴的不堪历史。现在挥向难民的鞭子占据了全部版面。
And the Secretary of Homeland Security saying the matter is now under investigation.
One cannot weaponize a horse, to aggressively attack a child. That is unacceptable. That is not what our policies and our training require. We will not tolerate mistreatment. And we will address it with full force based on the facts that we learn.
拜登面临越来越沉重的政治压力。
The Biden administration now on defense, from the president to the vice president.
What I saw depicted about those individuals on horseback treating human beings the way they were is horrible. And I fully support what is happening right now, which is a thorough investigation into exactly what is going on there. But human beings should never be treated that way.And I'm deeply troubled about it.
前总统川普以美国正成为粪坑来形容遭非法越境潮吞没的美国，共和党火力全开。
Do you bear responsibility for the crisis in Del Rio? Yes or no?
And Senator Josh Hawley laying in to Secretary Mayorkas on Capitol Hill.
Senator, the smuggling organizations?
Yes or no, Mr. Secretary? Do you bear responsibility for the humanitarian crisis in Del Rio? Yes or no?
Republicans slamming the Biden administration's actions, including the Texas governor at the border.
The Biden administration is a man-made disaster of inhumanity.Of epic proportions.
Governor Greg Abbott at the border today declaring they aren't welcome.
If you are targeting Texas to come to, we're going to show up in force and shut down the border.
州长还批联邦政府处理难民问题简直和撤离阿富汗一样糟糕。确实，不止桥下的难民营完美复制了喀布尔机场的惨状，在海地太子港机场也重演了喀布尔机场的混乱场景。 一群被遣返到太子港机场的难民试图冲上返回美国的飞机。
NBC News has learned Haitian migrants who were deported to Haiti today attacked pilots and immigration officers on another flight after it landed in Port-au-Prince.
机上人员见状仓皇关闭舱门，一只鞋狠狠砸在机门上。纽约时报说，美国边际巡逻机警行为引爆众怒，而拜登决定火速遣返数千人的决定也引发质疑。纽约时报不客气地说，拜登违背了他竞选总统的承诺。他说过要为逃离迫害和贫困的弱势家庭恢复庇护计划。事实上，九月中突然涌现在德州边境的海地难民潮，不能说和拜登毫不相干。时间回到今年二月，美国德州就开始有海地难民越境，并遭美国遣返。
Nearly 1,000 Haitians have been forced to return from the U.S. in February alone. It was just 50 in January before President Biden announced the moratorium.
Can you tell me all how you got here? Why are you here?
Et nous sommes ici. Nous traversons les frontières parce que nous étions des présidents et bien 100 jours. Pas de déportation, nous traversons.
Il y a même nous Miami.
Et nous demandons pour la presse à visiter prison.
可惜他们的遭遇没有更多人知道。
Most of these Haitians now arriving to the U.S. border have lived in Central or South America for years, finding refuge there after the 2010 earthquake that killed more than 200,000 in their homeland. They fled for countries like Chile and Brazil, which at the time needed workers and initially even offered humanitarian visas. 40,000 Haitians were living in Ecuador at the time, another 60,000 in Chile, and more than 95,000 in Brazil. But now, years later, as the pandemic endures and countries' economies increasingly tighten, many of those migrants set off to find refuge yet again, but further north.
然而，海地的悲剧还没有结束。今年七月，海地总统遭人暗杀，八月发生规模 7.2 地震，紧接着又遭逢飓风袭击。这个国家已经成了无法地带，无止境的天灾人祸和猖獗的黑帮没有未来。种种不幸叠加，造就了九月的大难民潮。
Aliuska Romero says she crossed 14 countries and risked her own life to get here.
Violaciones a las mujeres, a las niñas, a los niños, todo fue muy horrible.
She shows a cell phone video of the sharp cliff and the steep mountain she climbed in the thick jungles of Colombia.
When you say that there's a lot of dead people, what do you mean?
Muchos muertos porque te encuentras en el camino personas muertas, ahogadas, asesinadas.
Daria says he counted 17 dead.
He said that he saw dead women, dead children that were already decomposing. Said the bodies were on the side of the river. Y tenían que tomar esa agua. Did you have to drink that water?
And inside this tent, they say, was a pregnant woman who was left behind. Romero says she started crying, and Daria says he left her his food.
他们千辛万苦来到美国，以为川普走了，换上拜登就能够一圆美国梦。但是
，The DHS Secretary defending the deportations under the Trump era Title 42, which allows for swift expulsion of migrants due to COVID concerns.
So we expect four flights to depart today. We are working very closely with Haiti and other countries to which the migrants are being repatriated.
To escape deportation, some were forced to cross the Chesapeake River holding their children above their heads.
Even though this stretch of the Rio Grande is shallower, it is still dangerous. And here you have at least one family crossing with two small children trying to get back to the U.S. for processing.
But on the other side of the border, Mexico is also cracking down. Authorities took this man and child into custody. Here, a migrant is kicked in the head by Mexican immigration agents. And more migrants may be on the way. As many as 20,000, many of them Haitian, remain bottlenecked in Colombia, potentially awaiting their chance to continue their journey to the U.S.
Rumors of asylum in the U.S. were not true. The migrants crossed the river to the Mexican side for food to bring back to the campsite. But with officials here in Mexico also limiting their movements, they're essentially stuck with their greatest fear, deportation, quickly becoming a reality.
This is what Haitians are coming back to.
...依照国际法, 将寻求庇护者遣返到有可能受到迫害和生命威胁的地方是违法的。 不过, 遣返的班机, 仍在起飞。
Thousands so far loaded onto buses and planes bound for a one-way journey out of the United States.
Their destination, now the very place they first fled, the poorest nation in the Western Hemisphere.